Good morning.
Good morning. All right. So I'm going to do part of the workout that we did Monday in Jesus Jiving class. And we did it with the stability ball, which I'm sitting on right now. But I'm going to give you the devotion that we went over. And I know I did posted it on Facebook, but I wanted to do it right here. And so it'll be on YouTube. All right. James 2:22. Faith with action. Talking about Abraham offering his son Isaac to the altar to kill him, because that's what God asked him to do. I mean, can you imagine? But he was faithful. You see, he was trusting God so much that he was willing to do whatever God told him to do. His faith was made complete by what he did, by his actions. As you know, he didn't end up having to kill his son. God stopped him just before he did it. But look how faithful he was. God was faithful to him because Abraham trusted God. So we just need to trust God and be obedient to him. And he is right there. He is always in the gap for us, filling and for our provision. He never missed a beat. He's got it all aligned for each and every one of us. We just need to trust, be obedient, and just believe and follow him. Have you prayed and asked God to change a situation? I'm sure you have. We all do. There's a good chance his answer required action. We have to have action behind our prayers. We can't just pray and say, oh, Lord, I just pray that I lose 20 pounds and poof, you lose 20 pounds. No, it requires work. It requires commitment. And you know what? God wants you to feel the best that you can feel. So surrender all your health and fitness to him. Surrender your, when you pray, surrender it to him and say, God, I believe. And have and trust him. That's why I called this first month of this journey, this Jesus Jiving journey that I started on YouTube, training and trusting. We're training and trusting God. We're training physically and spiritually, and we're trusting God physically and spiritually. And so give it to him. Ask him to help you, to give you to help you with motivation. And you know what? When you work out for him, oh, you're going to have that motivation. And just before you even start your workout, just thank him for what he's done already and what he's going to do, because he is going to do a powerful thing. Just trust him. Be obedient and trust and believe. All right. Let's get started with the workout. I hope you got a ball, and we're going to begin with a warm-up. Make sure I'm not hitting anything. Make sure you have some room. That's why I came down here in my living room. Put on your own music. Your Jesus music. Alright. And switch. All right, You're going to do alternating front lunges at the ball game. So you're just using this ball. You don't have to. And you're just doing lunges. And you're alternating. We did a timer, but I forgot my timer, so we're just going to count. We can always make it work. And last one. Excellent. All right, next one. So you're just sidestep and up. If you want to advance it, you're doing jacks. Go to the beat. 2, 5, 7. Okay. Whew. You feel that one. You wouldn't think that you would. All right. Then let's do alternating figure eight. All right. So, you're moving the ball to figure eight. Again, you can do kicks. You put that jump in there. Do it for a little bit. Woo! Have fun with it. Alright, I'm going to just show you a little bit, and you can do these exercises. Do them for 40 seconds, 15 second rest, alright? So I'm going to go through them fast. 3 tall sumo squats. And twist ball. So you're going 1, 2, 3, twist. 1, 2, 3, twist. 2, 3, twist. 1, 2, 3, twist. 4. I really want to go for a walk because the sun is shining. I haven't had the sun in a few days. 3, 1, 2, 3, twist. 1, 2. You can lift up those heels. 2, 3. You're gonna feel it a little more in those inner thighs. All right. 15 second rest. Just go outside the sun. We're talking in here. Hey, you're going to do knee drives. You're going to do four on one side, four on the other. Two, three, and four. All right. One, two, three, four. 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 One, two. If you want, you can add a jump. I am not going to do a jump for this. Really engage those abs. Okay? This is an ab workout, heart workout, shoulder workout, leg workout. It's the works. That's what's so great about this ball. You don't have to get weights, but you're still working your shoulder, hanging under that ball. Alright? Alright, we're going on the floor. I gotta move this down a little. Okay, we're gonna do bridges. All right, you ready for this? So, you put your feet on the ball. And you're just lifting. Holding that ball in place, really push up. You're gonna feel it in your glutes, your quads, your hamstrings, and your abs. Really engage those abs. That protects your back. You will feel the burn. Guaranteed. We're just estimating 40 seconds because I forgot my clock. But you know what? We're going to do it. Get a few more. That's perfect. Whoa! Alright, now you're gonna do pull-ins. So your butt's off the floor and you're pulling in and pushing out. And in. Really engage those abs. Like I said, it protects your back. If you can't do both legs, one foot. And you can have on the floor, you're still gonna work the abs. And you gotta reset your feet every once in a while so the ball doesn't get away from you. We are free to live for Him. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, I am free because of Jesus. Oh, woo! Did you feel that, baby? All right, next one. Hand feet switch. Make sure your back stays flat on the floor. And you're just switching. Don't let the ball touch. Don't let on each side. The main thing is your back stays flat on the floor. If you only bring your legs down to here, that's fine. As long as your form is more important. That is the most important thing. Chairs are moving. I can't bring it down my way. You're still with me? You got this. In Christ, all things are possible. We are overcomers. Last one. We are overcomers. Remember that. Because of Him. All right. Now, you're going. Sit the ball and you're doing a crazy eight. So you're leaning back. Leaning back. Yes, we are free. Thank you, Jesus. All right, when we did these in Jesus 7, we did each of these realms 2 times, and then we moved to the next one. And like I said, we did each exercise 40 seconds, 15 second rest. All right. I don't know if I can do this here. So, you're going to put the ball against the wall. And you're going down and up. Down and up. Down and up. Make sure your knees are not going over your toes. Have those feet out far enough. You're going to feel it in your quads. The mat was slipping. That would not be good. I need to have that on my butt. All right. And pull. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Whoa. A little bonus there. Alright, so you can have a weight, and you're going to, I forgot a weight too, that's alright, it's all good. You're still, if you had no weight, you're still going to feel. You can have 2 weights, or 1, whatever works for you, and you're rolling. And your toes are up. And then heels are up as you're rolling. That way you're actually working your calves, your back, your shoulders, your legs. Alright, alternating side leg lifts. And you're doing a shoulder press. Shoulder side. Shoulder side instead of front kicks. You don't have to put the jump in. That's totally up to you. Just have fun. Thinking, guys, that you have the ability to move your body. Yes. Keep those abs engaged. Protect your back. It's so important. Ooh, the shoulders are on fire. Okay, we got one more. You're going to go on your knees with that run. Remember, do each round twice. I'm just doing it once to just give you guys an idea of what we did. You can be up or you can be defensive. And you're going side to side. Here go, dads. You can go up and down. We didn't do this, but you know what? I think I had a room more. And you're really working your quads. You're breathing. The obliques. Keep her going. Keep her going. I don't think it's been 40 seconds. Do you? Like I said, you're going to feel it in your shoulders. And look at, we haven't left. Use a bit of weight. And we're feeling it in your shoulders. Cross your legs. Your body weight.
All right. So the hip thrust. This workout, I have to say, it was fun. So your shoulders are on the ball. All right, let me try this again. Your shoulders. You want to kind of roll it down. And you're going up. You can have weights here. And really squeeze the booty. This is a booty exercise. And the abs. You're going to work your abs. You can have your hands here if you don't have weights. Or you can lay it right on the ball. And you can just do a little move. You're going to feel it more actually with a little move. And not going down very well. Go to the beat. One. Two. Those pulses will get you every time. Two, three, four, seven, eight, nine, and ten. Woo-hoo. And then we did a hip thrust with chest flies. So, I'm here again, and you have weights, and you're doing chest flies. Again, you can lay your head down there, or you can hold it up. If you're up more like this, you're going to feel more in your abs. Obviously the chest, the whole chest flies. All right. You're gonna sit on the ball. And you have those weights and just bounce. And you're doing alternating shoulder press. This one's so fun. Whew. You ever feel like a mess? You know what? Jesus can fix that mess. No matter what it is. Speed her up. Woo! My ladies really like this one. Jesus Java move. Bounce, 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 bounce. Using those hands. Remember, you have weights in your hands. I just forgot him and I was like, you know what, we're gonna make it work. Alright, so you're just rolling the ball. And you're lifting your heels and toes as you roll up. Move those arms. And if you want, you can still have those weights in your hands. And you can even roll this way. You're working your back. You can change an exercise up. It doesn't matter. I'm just a guide for you. Your motivation. Inspiration. Encouraging you to move that body. Bam. Ready? And one. All right. Oh, I wanted to tell you. That is it for the cardio. We'll do a cool down. Like I said, do two rounds. Do two sets of each round. All right. But look at the Jesus driving. Sure. We got tanks. We got t-shirts. And it's also on the front. If you want, it's a cross with weights and it says Jesus Dragon. Asta, White Needham. You did an amazing job. All right, let's cool it down. push that ball. And you can do your own pull down. Make up what you need. Alright. I'm just showing you some real quick ones. Lay it on the ball like this. The curvature of your... Alright, there's one. And one more I'll show you. This we're just doing a little slower. It's what we started out with. But a lot of times, your warm up and your cool down, you do the same thing. Because you're stretching those same muscles out that you just used. You can sit on that ball, stretching those shoulders. Make sure your shoulder's not up by your chin. Leave it down. And then other side. All right. I'll post this. And if you do this workout, let me know. I want to hear it. And I want to hear your thoughts on it. All right. And let me know if you want to order one of these Jesus Jiving tanks or a t-shirt. And we'll get them ordered for you. They're $20 each. All right. We'll see you soon. And I love you guys. Thanks for hopping on with me. Have an amazing, amazing, blessed day. And just thank the Lord above. And get outside. Go for a walk. Go for a run. Whatever you do, get out in nature. Enjoy God's creation. All right. It's a beautiful. The sun is shining finally after 3 days. All right. See ya. Love ya.